This is Mount St. Helens in the spring of 1979. Along with Mount Rainier, Mount Hood, and others, St. Helens was formed due to the Juan de Fuca Plate, subducting under the states of Washington and Oregon, creating an arc of volcanoes known as the Cascade Range. Mount St. Helens had been dormant for over 100 years, during which time, rising magma from the subducting plate began to accumulate under the mountain, and on March 20th, 1980, the mountain began to tremble. Molten rock shifting under St. Helens triggered a shallow earthquake swarm, peaking on the 25th of March and lessening on the 29th, once a newly formed fracture system at the mountain's summit excavated a crater 75 meters in width, venting small quantities of volcanic ash. On April 1st, 1980, the first harmonic tremors were detected. Harmonic tremors, usually associated with large movements of magma and outgassing, were a sign of impending eruption, putting Washington in a state of emergency. The crater size gradually grew through the week, from 75 to 400 meters in diameter, and was more than 150 meters deep by April 7th. By mid-April, USGS surveyors began to measure the north face of the mountain, which was visibly bulging outwards at a rate of up to 1.8 meters per day. Between May 7th and May 18th, over 10,000 earthquakes were recorded in the region as the bulge reached its maximum size. Then, on the morning of May 18th, 1980, Mount St. Helens finally gave way to its internal stresses. A 5.1 magnitude earthquake triggered the largest landslide in recorded history, sending 3 cubic kilometers of material to the north. The landslide exposed the volcano's magma, causing a massive lateral blast in the same direction as the landslide, creating pyroclastic flows that briefly passed the speed of sound. The event was the deadliest volcanic incident in the history of the United States. In total, 57 people lost their lives, though this number is disputed. 1.8 million cubic meters of ash had to be removed from highways and airports in Washington state alone, at a removal cost in upwards of $2 million. Over 200 houses were destroyed directly, as were 47 major bridges and 300 kilometers of highways. As a result of the damaged infrastructure, unemployment in Washington skyrocketed, and a crippling blow was dealt to the tourism industry. It cost $1.1 billion to repair the damage directly, but the real financial cost of the disaster cannot be determined. The area north of Mount St. Helens was described by Jimmy Carter as looking like the moon. Rampant volcanic mudslides called lahars choked all the surrounding rivers and buried large swaths of landscape that were not already covered in ash from the blast. 300 square kilometers of forest were destroyed by the eruption, the majority of which were blown over by a shockwave, the rest killed by the heat energy alone. The state of Washington estimated that nearly 7,000 big game animals perished in the area, along with almost all birds and small mammals. Downwind from the volcano, many food crops were snuffed out due to the thick ash accumulation. Ash fell as far west as Minnesota and as far south as Colorado. To this day, St. Helens and the area that surround it are scarred by the events of 1980. The mountain was irreparably blown apart, and much of the land to the north of the mountain remains barren. Mount St. Helens released 24 megatons of thermal energy, equivalent to 1,500 times the yield of the atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima. Broken timber from the eruption remains in Spirit Lake. However, the landscape that was devastated by the eruption has evolved into a rich and diverse habitat for plants and animals, and the world's youngest glacier has been forming in the eruption crater since 1986. Despite how destructive the eruption event was, Mount St. Helens remains a natural laboratory for the study of Earth's processes, and also serves as an example of ecosystem response to extreme events.